Daryl Hilbert here for the Fur Getters with Rob Salina. And if you remember, Rob Salina is our trapping CEO of the Fur Getters. And we're taking a look at his newest invention here. This is a trap, preferably, hopefully, a bobcat trap.
So there's not a lot of innovative design here. A lot of people make these traps. They make them just about the same way, but they'll usually use a flat piece of 1x1 square mesh. I couldn't find anything I could find in that realm was extremely expensive. So I just bought a roll of 1x2 and made sure that it was 12.5 gauge. Most of this that you find is gonna be 14 gauge. It was just too thin. So I went with 12.5 gauge. It seems to be do a good job. And also most people will attach with just these hog rings in every spot here. What I did was I cut these long and I wrapped the wire of the cage around the frame.
Which, wow, nice and tight.
Yeah, and I can't tell you how tedious that was. That process right there. I don't know if I would do that again.
I can imagine. you did a great job on that though.
But it's the frame is just 1/4-inch rod. I had to buy almost all of this material. A lot of people build it out of what they have laying around. I didn't have the right stuff laying around. I think the only thing that I didn't buy was this rebar I had laying around, but the rest of it I had to buy. I built two of them, and I ended up with about probably $65 in materials, maybe $70 in materials for each trap because I had to buy everything.
Okay.
The wire was cheap, but steel and everything was, you know, even like these, you know, these were a few bucks a piece. It all adds up.
Right.
A lot of people don't put these on. This is just, I wish I would have done a better job. It's like a hinge or something, but we're getting close to the season, so I just did it this way. And this is just, I like this option. I like having a bait door back here so I can reach down in the trap and do this instead of having to reach all the way in from the end and put bait or whatever I need in there.
Oh yeah.
So right. I like having a door here. It's not particularly, you know, I've just got wrapped around here with 9 wire and I tack welded the 9 wire. I kind of had to hurry up and get this part done, but it works. It's functional.
Yeah, right. Well, that's good. Man, that's you did a great job. I mean, it's just a work of art, even if you don't put it out to trap anything. It's just...
Yeah, I think we'll put it out to trap something. Actually, the season started yesterday, so I'd like to get it out. So it's a guillotine door. This is what holds it from anything coming out.
Okay.
Pull that back. That's just the lock. That's a guillotine door. I cut these rails. The pan comes up. The rod and the pan just comes up underneath the door. Set the door. Come around this side. You just set the door right on there.
Okay, yeah.
And then when he steps on the pan...
Didn't look like you used much pressure at all.
I've got 3 pounds of tension on it is what I ended up with, which is what I wanted. You can't really adjust it. You probably could by bending an angle into this if you wanted to. Bend this up a little bit would probably give you a little more tension.
Okay.
But it's 3 pounds is where I want it.
Yeah, I don't think you want a lot of tension or else he'll be eaten and he'll have a little incline which he eats upon.
These rails are, they were a piece of just 3/4-inch square stock, and I just cut one side of it off with a grinder and a cutting wheel. Nothing fancy.
Well, it is fancy. It's pretty nice. Pretty nice looking.
I also added an option for, say you get a skunk or something in here. Most people just use a tarp or something and sneak up on it and lay it over, and then they can come up and open the door gently and let the skunk walk out. I don't like that.
Yeah.
So I added an option. And so what we do is we tie rope down here, comes up over the top, and then a rope here to release this catch.
Okay.
So you pull the first rope and release the catch. You pull the second rope from 20 feet away or however long you want your rope, and it lifts up the door.
Nice.
And then there's a loop in the rope that comes back and hooks onto here. And that will hold the door open so I can, from 20 feet away, I can open this gate and leave it open if I want to get rid of a skunk.
Yeah. Well, Rob, this is a great job. I'm excited for you to put it out and then for us to be able to check it. And you said you're kind of hoping to do some get some bobcat this year.
That is what this was built for specifically.
Okay. Bobcat. All right.
It is 12 inches wide, 18 inches high, and 36 inches long.
Okay. So I wonder what other animals you could catch in it.
Anything that you want to bait it for.
You think a coyote could get in there?
You could catch a coyote in there.
Okay.
I've seen videos of people catching coyotes in these, but I think it seems to me like it'd be kind of tough. Just there's a lot of metal smell and everything. I've got my hands all over it.
Well,
you know how finicky coyotes are about scent. Bobcats really don't seem to care.
Right.
I've seen videos where people set these out for bobcats and caught coyotes.
Okay. Well, that is awesome, and definitely looking forward to seeing if we can't catch something. And we need to also get out and do some calling. We haven't been calling for a while.
Yeah, I haven't been out at all. And out on our place where I'll be setting these traps on my private land, there's just not a lot of coyotes this year. There's not a lot out there.
So, I've been hearing a lot of that. I suppose it's true. I've shot 17 this year. That includes going out in the summer, but I don't get one every time I go out. Yeah.
The bobcats are actually causing me issue, and that's why I went with these live traps, because they're coming into my yard and attacking our barn cats. They've killed a couple of them and tore another one to pieces, and we got him fixed up, but I don't want to catch my barn cats in these traps, you know, in a foothold trap.
So. Right.
And I'm setting these in places where they like to wander down in the draws sometimes. So I don't.
So
that's why I went with a cage trap.
Well, anyway, this is great, Rob. Thanks for bringing this by. Our headquarters is here at the church. but anyway, that looks great, and I'm excited about it. And we will keep you posted with more footage. So this is Rob Salina and Daryl Hilbert for the Fur Getters.